And when it seeped to the top, I came out of the mess that I was in. But let me say that people say that homosexuality is one of the hardest things to come out of. They don't even know what they're talking about. Anything that has you in bondage is hard to come out of. People keep going back to stuff. They go, everybody, go, there's tons of people that keep going, running back and out of adultery, out of whoremongering, out of lying, out of thieving, out of all kinds of stuff that they used to do, and they keep going, running back and forth. So there's no, sin is sin. There's no sin that God cannot overcome. There's no sin that is too difficult that God cannot call you out. And there's no sin that we cannot be stayed out from. You have to have a made up mind. Your mind must be made up. Without a made up mind, you can't stay out of nothing. Unless the drug addict has a made up mind, he'll be pulled back into that situation. If an alcoholic doesn't have a made up mind, they're going to go back to that bottle. You have to have a made up mind, because there's things, the devil is going to present things that's going to make you want to go back. If I find myself having a thought, God immediately pulls me. I do not linger in thoughts that are not of God. I don't linger in longings that are not of God. I'm not going to linger there. I'm not going to do it. I have a made up mind. And my mind is to serve God and to serve God only. And another master, the master that had me captive, I am not going to serve him ever again. Ever, ever, ever again. I have a made up mind. But people didn't change me. People didn't pull me out. People didn't call me. It was God that called me out. And in this chapter, John 6, Jesus says, verse 44, no man can come to me except the Father which hath sent me draw him. Unless God draws us, we cannot come. When he began to break down the wall and he began to break me down, and he knows how to bring us to our knees. He knows how to get us to start coming to church. He did it because of a job that I was on. It was the worst job I ever had. I've told this story many times since I've been doing this broadcast. But it was through that job. I never was in a place that people didn't like me. I was never in a place that I had so much confusion. First of all, I never worked with all black people in my whole entire life until I worked on this job. And I won't say that all the confusion came because they were black. There were marvelous people on that job. But the people that were in control of that, who were my immediate supervisor, even though I was a manager, God had hardened his heart against me and had hardened many of the other managers against me. And they were those who liked me, but they weren't in control. They were people that basically worked under me, and people mostly of them I had hired, because I hired practically everybody that worked in that place. But God knows where to put you at and what to do to bring you out. And if God did not desire to bring me out, I would still be there. And so if indeed that lifestyle is a lifestyle agreeable to God, then why would he have a need to bring me out? He would not have brought me out if it had been a lifestyle that was agreeable to him. Evidently, it was not agreeable to him. If you read the text, if you get into his word, it tells you that man shall not lay with man. He tells it's an abomination to him. Homosexuality is an abomination. Woman laying with woman is an abomination. God hates it. And so whatever he hates, he hates it. It doesn't mean he hates you. It means he hates what you're doing. If you're a whoremonger, he hates what you're doing. If you're a liar, he hates what you're doing. But it is God that does the correcting. Man cannot correct you. I will never talk about drugs. I will never talk about alcoholism. I don't know. That's not my experience. That's not the life that I have. I've never drank. I was never a smoker, really. I tried to smoke, but it didn't work. The principal caught me. And when and under the threat of my parents being called, that broke me. And so I never tried smoking from the day that principal caught me, because my parents hearing about that would have killed me. And so we serve a God who will kill us in the end. We will die. If you desire eternal life, if you desire not to go down into the pit, do not follow foolishness because you want to lay with men and believe that because God loves you. He loves you, but he doesn't love what you're doing. He loves you. He loves every sinner out there. He loves us all. He created us all. He loves everything. He said when he finished creating that it was good. He loves us. But the devil has corrupted everything, and he's turned our minds, and he's given us these diverse spirits, and he's given us to take off and follow different patterns of things that are not godly. And when you fall prey to the things of the devil and you start believing that this is who you are, this is what you were, God didn't create you to be. I used to believe that it was my chemical makeup. I used to believe that. That is not true. It's false. It's false. God is not a God of confusion. Get in his word. Study the word of the Lord. Study it for yourself. He is God. There is no confusion in him. He makes it plain. It's plain in his book. Understand who he is. He does love you. He will bless you and continue to bless you. But you need to walk in the steps that he has ordered. Don't walk in your own understanding, but walk in God's understanding. Become acceptable to God. Do his will and his will only. Don't follow the things that you want to do. Follow the things that God desires for you to do. He is God, and I thank him for his marvelous word. I thank him for you. I thank him because of you. I thank him because he is who he is. I thank him for my experience that I'm able to share and know beyond a shadow of doubt who he is and how he operates, that I can speak to things that other people cannot speak to. I live my life following him, but I didn't always follow him. My ears were closed to him. My way was another way. But he called me out. He set me free. And now I walk in liberty. I thank God. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you because you are a Savior. I thank you because you love me and you desired me and you never turned your back on me. I thank you. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you. It is for such a time as this. Get into the word of the Lord. Study it for yourself. He is God. God bless you. He saved a wretch like me. God bless you. Jesus.